Dear audience and viewer, you are welcome to a digital presentation on different aspect of the cut and sew knitwear, popularly known as light knitwear. The purpose of this digital presentation is to introduce you the different aspects of cut and sew knitwear. Knitwear is an important component of ready-made garments, and Bangladesh is one of the most important knitwear manufacturing countries of the world. The growth of knitwear in Bangladesh is spectacular, and the existing growth rate projects are prospective future of Bangladesh in the world market. Before elaborating the whole process on cut and sew knitwear, let us look on what is knitwear and how cut and sew knitwear can be described. Garments are made from fabric, and fabric comes from yarn, and yarn comes from fiber. There are different types of fabric, but the main fabrics can be of two types. One is woven and the other is knit fabric. The knit fabric is manufactured basically by different methods of knitting like circular knitting and flatbed knitting, etc. The woven fabrics is manufactured by weaving using different kind of weaving machine like hand loom and power loom, etc. In the weaving process, fabric is manufactured by interlacement of two sets of yarn at right angles. In the knitting process, fabric is manufactured by interlocking of loops. And the garment which is made from knitted fabric structure is known as knitwear. Based on the different process of garment construction, knitwear can be classified into two. One is called cut and sew knitwear or light knitwear, and the other is fully fashioned knitwear or heavy knitwear or sweater. Polo shirts, t-shirts, tank tops, skirt, etc. are from cut and sew knitwear, and these are manufactured by cutting and sewing of knitted fabric. And sweaters, pullovers, jumpers and cardigan are fully fashioned knitwear. Now let's enter into a composite knitwear factory to see the production procedure as per sequences of production. manufacture knitted fabric, different types of yarn are used, like 100% cotton combed and carded quality, CVC to value cotton, 100% polyester, etc. Various types of fabrics are used in cotton sewn knitwear. Mostly used fabrics are single jersey, rib knitted structure, interlock or double jersey pique or lacoste and fleece. Different types of knitting machines are used to manufacture different category of knitted fabrics, like single jersey knitting machine, rib knitting machine, interlock or lacoste knitting machine. Machines are different gauges and dyers. Circular knitting machine can be classified into two. One is small dyer machine and other is large dyer machine, and mostly used gauges are 14G, 18G, 24G, etc. Machine dyer ranges are 18 inches to 52 inches. To produce fancy type knitted fabric can be used jacquard knitting machine. We'll be right back. Fabric dyeing is a process where the impregnation of the fabric is done in a dye solution to achieve a single uniform shade throughout the batch of the fabric. Different types of dyes are used for dyeing operation. Dyes are mostly colored organic compound, capable of imparting color to the textile. Various types of dyes are used, like basic dyes, sulfur dyes, reactive dyes, dispersed dyes, bad dyes, etc. It is to be mentioned that different dyes are used for different textile materials. Reactive dyes are mostly used in knitted fabrics. After coloration, the fabric it requires to give final treatment, popularly known as fabric finishing or textile finishing. Textile finishing is the final stage in the treatment of textiles. To improve the aesthetic value of the fabrics, to improve the durability of the fabric, to improve the softness of the fabric. That is to prepare them for garment manufacturers or consumers. Finishing technique depends on nature of the fabric, that is physical properties of the fabrics, end uses of the fabrics. In the finishing stage, we have different kind of machines like compacting machine, roll calendar machine, heat setting machine, etc. purpose of fabric inspection is to ensure that the fabric specifications are conformed and the defect level or defect range is within acceptable tolerance. After receiving the finished fabric, some inspector inspects the fabric roll by different methods. But the most common method is four-point system, which is popularly known as American Apparel Manufacturer Association point grading system for determining fabric quality. During inspection, some common defects can be observed like shading, holes, laddering, needle mark, oil mark, calendar, shining spot, puckering, slop, knots, etc. At this stage, fabrics are laid in a long cutting table by a spreader machine. After that, marker man mark the paper based on pattern. Garment pattern is developed by pattern master. Pattern could be manually or computerized. Marker efficiency is higher in CAD. Then marked paper is set on the fabric and cutting man cut the fabric. Thank you. Sorting and bundling of cut fabric is done based on color and size ratio. Equipment used in cutting room are electric knife such as straight knife, bent knife, GSM scale and cutter, measurement tape, metal gloves, scissors, cutting table, marker paper, numbering card, bundling card, clamp, etc. At this stage, different garment panels are attached together. Labeling also done in this section. Different types of sewing machines are used in sewing section, like single needle lock stitch machine, double needle lock stitch machine, different types of overlock machine, flat lock machine, interlock machine, buttonhole machine, button attached machine, bar tack machine, etc. Effective type of sewing system combined with new plant layout and new sewing machine can give significant advantages in many market areas. To produce any products, we should consider the suitable system. There are various types of sewing system like progressive bundle system, unit production system, modular manufacturing system, Toyota sewing system, etc. Inspection is a process to compare with a standard. After attachment of different garment panel, the sewing inspectors check the whole garment. The criteria of the inspection checklist: taking garment measurement, seam puckering, drop stitch, mismatched thread, etc. The objective of the knitwear ironing is to improve the aesthetic value of the garment. It requires light steam for ironing. Thank you. At this stage, price tag attaching, folding, primary packaging, secondary packaging and final packaging are done as per the buyer's specification. Finally, goods are ready for export.